Hello. Today I will introduce the notion of concurrent states, or also known as parallel states, which is an extension of the notion of composite states. And we will do this based on our favorite running example, which is the digital clock. So as you can see here on the left-hand side of the screen, I have already prepared for you a clock with two substates to display the clock and to set the hour and minutes of the clock. And both states contain two more substates. So what we would like to do now is to extend this behavior with the behavior of a chime function. So the idea of this chime function is that every minute, for example, or every hour, there will be a sound that will be ringing, and you can activate or deactivate this chime function. So let me start adding this behavior. To do this, I will start by creating a new state here in the set substate, which I will call activate chime. And well, this will be linked by a transition from set minutes to activate chime with the set event associated to it. And then we will move this transition here so that our application continues to function. Now, for the moment, we haven't done anything special, so we still have to add some behavior to activate or deactivate the chime. So here I will add a new transition from chime to itself. To close the palette for a while, like this. And what we will do is, whenever we receive the mode event, we will modify the value of some Boolean variable that we have to define, which we will call chime. And basically, what we will do is we will toggle the variable from of this Boolean value. So if it used to be true before, it will become false. If it used to be false before, it will become true. So like this, we can activate or deactivate the chime functionality. Of course, if we want to do this, we have to add a new variable, a new Boolean variable, chime. Otherwise, it will not work. Okay, so with this, we have added the possibility to activate or deactivate a chime. And now comes the interesting part. What we want to do now is to add an extra region in this clock state that will run in parallel with the existing region. So if you already wondered before, why do composite states have inside a rectangle that's called R1? Basically, this means that inside the clock state, there is a region, and in this region, we have other substates inserted in it. So now we want to run in parallel another region with other behavior inside to specify what to do to activate or deactivate the chime. So to do this, I will create a new region inside clock here. Let's just call it R2, which is a second region. And okay, apparently I already have two regions, so maybe that's a little bit too much. And in this second region that I just created, I'm going to add some substates. Of course, we always have to have an initial state and a transition to the first state in this region. Let's start. When the system starts, the chime will be off, and then we can go to a chime that will be on. And to a third state with a chime that is ringing, or sound, where a sound is ringing. Let's call it chime sounds, chime rings. Okay, and between all of these states, we're going to put transitions. I will add the events associated to them straight away. Okay. So basically here, the idea is we start in the initial state where the chime is off. To turn the chime on, we will make use of this variable chime, which I have defined here on the left-hand side. Let's say that by default, the value is false, like this. And then here, we will simply put, rather than putting an event, we will put a condition where we will just check the value of this Boolean condition. If the value is true, so basically between these parentheses, we will put chime, which means we'll verify the value of this Boolean variable. If it's true, we will go from the state chime off to chime on. To go in the inverse direction, we will verify the negation. So we will verify if the chime variable is false. So like this, we can toggle between chime off and chime on. Now here we have, when the chime is on, we would like to be able to start ringing a certain sound every, for example, every hour. Whenever there's a new hour that starts, we can start ringing a sound. Here, for the sake of the example, I will do this every 1 minute, because otherwise we don't want to wait for 1 hour when we are simulating the application. So to do this, I will of course make use of my time function, which we know is ticking every second. So basically what I want to do is every 60 seconds, I want to be able to go to the chime rings state. So here the condition that I will specify is that when time modulo every 60 seconds, so when time modulo 60 is equal to 0, in that case, I want to go to the chime rings state. Okay, and when do I go back? I will go back from chime rings to chime on, let's say after 5 seconds. So we will keep on ringing for 5 seconds. Normally it should be 1 or 2 seconds or so, but I will put it a little bit higher so that you can clearly see during the simulation what will be happening. Okay, now the only thing that's left is that I have to specify in the chime rings what we will have to do. So here, when we enter the chime rings, we will start ringing a bell. So there we will define a function ring that will be the entry action of the state. So to do this, of course, I need to define an operation here to ring, which doesn't return any value. And like this, the application should be complete. So let us now run the example to see what's happening. So I'm saving and starting the simulation. And now we see that when our clock is running, we are in two substates at the same time. To start with, we are displaying the hour, and at the same time, we are also in the chime off state. So we are in the first state of the second region and simultaneously in the initial state of the first region. I will also here on the left, on the right, make this a little bit bigger. So here we can see the different variables used. We see that the chime is indeed false for now. So let's start with some events. So I'm clicking on the set button, which will move to set hour. I'm not going to modify the hour. I'm going to once more to set the minutes. I will not do anything here. I will go to the activate chime function, and then here I will modify the value of chime again by clicking on the mode button. Like this, now we see that the value of chime has been set to true, and here, because now the value used to be 0 seconds, we are in the chime rings functionality. After 5 seconds, we go back to the chime on. Here, but in the meantime, I'm still in the activate chime function. I can use the set event to go back. This doesn't affect at all the behavior of the chime. As we can see, the chime is still activated here. So they are really two sub-machines that are running in parallel. So to continue, I will wait for a couple more seconds to show you again that the Chai will keep on ringing. So just keep a look on this seconds variable. As soon as it will be at the value of 60, then we will go back from chime on to chime ring for 5 seconds, and we go back automatically to chime on. So we're almost there, and here we go back to the chime rings. The sound is ringing. Okay, we don't hear it here because I haven't implemented this function, and then we go back to chime on. If we want to deactivate the chime again, we can do this by using the behavior specified on the left hand side. So I can use the set button. Okay, I need to do this 3 times to go to the activate chime. And here, if I now use the mode button, I will change the Boolean value chime from true to false, which will have as an effect that this condition will be triggered, and we will also go at the same time to the chime off state. So if I click on this here, effectively we see that the chime is now deactivated. So this is a very simple example in which you see the use of parallel regions. So there are different state machines on the left hand side and on the right hand side that are running in parallel and that depend on each other, in this case by means of some Boolean variable on the left that triggers changes on the right.